Hello there, and welcome to another tutorial. I'm John Riddle, and today I've got a great one for you. We're going to show you how to use Canva. Canva is a great platform where you can go and find tools and templates and everything you need to create graphics. For today's tutorial, we're going to be using the free online version of Canva. So let's get started. First of all, access Canva by going to canva.com and make sure you're logged in to access the main page. In this video, we're going to use the web version of Canva through a web browser. You can also download the Canva app for your computer for a faster and smoother performance. All the projects you make in Canva are called designs and can be anything from documents to presentations, social media posts, videos, and much more. At the top, select Your Designs to browse through your most recent projects. Switch to Templates to search among the millions of templates available in Canva. These come with predefined aspect ratios and sizes ready to use. Open the newest Canva AI to generate complete project with the help of AI that you can later customize for your needs. This includes generating an image, creating entire document pages, or even designing complete presentations with different versions to choose from. This helps you save loads of time. To learn how to use Canva, we will start from a new empty project and see how to edit it with the free version to create social media posts, videos, presentations, and documents. Let's start by creating a social media post. Since Canva Free does not include the resize option, you have to select the correct one from the start. For example, let's select social media and choose Instagram post, coming with its standard and predefined size. If you need to set your own, head to Custom Size on the left and set your own dimensions in pixels. The new Canva project opens on the main interface, completely empty. You can import any ready template from the Design tab on the left, which sets background, content, colors, and style that you can edit and customize. Let's search for something related to the sea and choose this template. This comes with everything ready to use, such as text, media, or graphics, which are called elements. You can zoom in and out by holding Control or Command and scrolling with your mouse wheel. Editing is very simple. Click on any element to select it and right-click to copy and paste it. To remove the element, right-click and go to Delete. To undo any action, use Control or Command and Z. You can click and drag elements to move them and use their nodes to scale. To edit text, double-click inside it, type your content, and click outside to apply and move it as needed. To further edit any element, select it and use the options at the top, which change depending on the element type. Select any image or graphic item, like this one, and go to Crop to crop it, picking a specific aspect ratio on the left or by adjusting the nodes directly on the preview. Click Done to apply. Go to flip the item horizontally or vertically. With Stroke Style, add a stroke, which is applied around the border of the image box. Set its thickness, set its style, and define its color. You can also adjust transparency. Or click on Position to place the element precisely by setting exact coordinates or defining the size. Under Arrange, set the order of visibility in case your image is overlapped by others. With Canva, you can also make photo corrections. Select a photo and head to Edit at the top to open several tools on the left. On Adjust, apply auto corrections with the help of AI, or set color temperature, tint, brightness, and contrast on your own. If you own the Pro plan, you can perform advanced corrections with AI. We won't see these in this beginner tutorial. You can also apply photo filters or effects. For example, some blur. You can also apply further creative modifications by using the Canva apps. We won't cover these in this beginner tutorial. Now, let's see how to edit text. Double-click on it and select any text to change its font family, size, color, style, and alignment. You can also go to Advanced Settings to set letter and line spacing. Add transparency if needed, or go to Effects to apply special effects such as shadows, neon styles, and more. With text selected, use Magic Write to edit or rewrite it instantly, or change its tone to make it more fun. By default, any new design project starts with a single page. You can add more pages by selecting Add Page at the bottom. These pages share the same background unless they're covered by an image, as in this example. To change the page background color, select a page and go to Background Color at the top. If you do not want a plain background, apply another ready template from Design on the left. At the bottom, under Pages, you can see all your page thumbnails displayed as storyboards. You can switch to a timeline preview by going to Duration in the bottom left corner. Each page is shown as a video clip lasting 5 seconds by default. You can preview by clicking on the timeline to place its marker in time and pressing the spacebar key. You can also adjust each page duration by dragging its inner edges. Click on Add Audio to add a music track or narration. You can record your voice by enabling your microphone or generate an AI voice instead. If you own a paid plan, you can also browse a large collection of music tracks you can use for your designs. If you have your own audio file, go to Uploads and then to Upload Files. Once the upload is complete, click and drag the file onto the timeline to add it. By default, the audio file will match the total duration of your project, but you can easily trim or extend it by dragging its edges. When you select the audio track, you'll see several options at the top, such as adjusting its volume or adding fade-in and fade-out transitions to control how the sound starts or ends. To add transitions between pages, right-click on any page and go to Add Transition. This adds a transition effect between the current page and the next one. Transitions are shown as violet sections between two pages. Now let's go back to the Pages view. The second page was made using a template, but we can go to Elements on the left to insert additional photos, graphics, stickers, shapes, and other visuals to customize your page as needed. Open Magic Media on the left to create new media with the help of AI. You can generate images, graphics, or videos by describing what you want at the bottom, then choosing the style and layout, including the aspect ratio. When ready, click Generate at the bottom. Then, select the media you want to import on your design. Go to Text on the left to add new text elements. For example, you can insert an independent text box. Just double-click to edit its content, then click outside to apply, and click and drag it to move it wherever you like. With Magic Write, you can get more inspiration using AI. You can ask it to describe a topic or write paragraphs to copy into your design or even provide any file as input. You can also add smooth animations by selecting any page or element and going to Animate at the top. Choose the type of animation you like from the available options on the left. and set whether it must be applied, when the element appears, exits, or both. To preview your project in full screen, go to Preview in the top right corner. To export your project, go to Share. You can share your design with others on Canva, or simply copy a link outside the platform. Select Download to download your project for offline use, choosing several formats including PDF or MP4 if your design is animated. The free version of Canva allows you to export up to 1080p HD quality. There are also other options available, for example, to publish directly on social media such as Instagram. All projects in Canva are saved automatically, as shown by this icon at the top. You get all your Canva projects listed on the home page under Recent Designs, or in the Project section on the left. With Canva, you can also create videos by going to Video. Choose your preferred aspect ratio, for example, a 1080p HD resolution. At this point, customize the content, just as seen with the Instagram post before. Apply templates from the Design tab, add graphics, media, stickers from Elements, pieces of text, or import your own media from uploads. For example, you can upload an image and drag it onto the timeline to create a new page, adjusting its duration by dragging its inner edges. Now let's see how to make presentations with Canva. From the home page, select Presentation and open a new project. This will have 1080p HD resolution with 16:9 aspect ratio, perfect for screens. Each page represents a slide which you can fill using templates from the Design tab. For example, this one for the first slide and this one for the second. As shown before, you can edit all elements inside, move them around, edit text, adjust objects, and add animations or files as needed. Select any page and go to Animate at the top to add animation effects to the whole page and to all the elements within it. You can also add new pages at the bottom and apply transitions by right-clicking on any page. Select any page and go to Animate at the top to add animation effects to the whole page and to all the elements within it. As already seen, open Duration to check or adjust the timings, especially if you export the presentation as a video. By default, each slide lasts 5 seconds. When ready, go to Share to share it within Canva or with a link, or head to Download to export it as a PDF or a PowerPoint PPTX file. To showcase your slides on the entire screen, go to Present Full Screen. The default slide duration is ignored, as you can move through slides by clicking with your mouse or using the arrow keys on your keyboard. In the bottom right corner, you get several tools. Draw directly on the slides. Use magic shortcuts to add live effects. Open Canva Live to launch an interactive live session. Start a new session and share the QR code or the code your audience can insert when visiting canva.live. You can also switch to Presenter View to get two windows, one for your audience and another for you to view your notes and keep control of the session. To end the presentation, press the Escape key or click on Exit Presentation from the Presenter View. You can also record yourself while presenting by going to Present, then to Present and Record. This feature works only on Google Chrome browsers. Start capturing your session. Allow permissions for webcam and microphone, and test them before launching the recording. When done, click End Recording to save or download your video. With Canva, you can also create documents by going to Docs on the home page. This starts completely blank. You can fill it using ready-made templates from the Design tab, If you start from a blank page, you can type the document title and press Enter to continue with the first paragraph as body text. Each time you press Enter, you create a new independent paragraph. The document page automatically extends to fit all your lines. If you want to create a new and independent page, open the page thumbnails and click on the plus button. Select any text or paragraph to change its style using the toolbar at the top. You can also adjust the alignment and add indentation to the lines you've selected. You can also use Magic Write to improve your writing, correct errors, or use another style. Whereas, go to Link to add a hyperlink to a website or to another page within the document. Use the plus button on the left to add new headings or subheadings. You can also create bulleted or numbered lists, pressing Enter to move to the next point and pressing Enter twice to end the list. From the left panel, you can also add other elements, such as banners, shapes, or colored columns. Include sheets, customizable charts, but also images or videos. In documents, elements always stay in line with the text, so they move automatically when adding or deleting lines. You can still click and drag any element to move it through the text lines. When your document is ready, go to share it with others within Canva or through a link, or select Download to export your document for offline use, choosing between a PDF or a DocX format. Hey, thanks for watching today's tutorial on Canva. We hope you learned something new about Canva, something you didn't know already. And remember, for more tips, tricks, and many other tutorials, be sure to visit our YouTube channel or our website.